All right, this is fifth grade module 3, lesson 7, and we're going to be using tape diagrams to solve two-step word problems. All right, Christine baked a pumpkin pie, and she ate a sixth of the pie, and then her brother ate a third of it, and then gave the leftovers to his friends. What fraction did he give to his friends? So we're going to draw a single tape diagram here, and that's the whole thing. And without worrying about making the sizes appropriate, like ratio, proportional, we're going to say that Christine ate a sixth, her brother ate a third. By the way, it's kind of fun if you're a teacher here. Ask students, well, what's bigger, one-sixth or one-third? And watch the students as they struggle with figuring out, well, what is bigger? Is one-sixth bigger or is one-third bigger? And then we're told that the rest goes to his friends, so that's our question mark right here. And this whole thing counts as one whole pumpkin pie. So our strategy is first we're going to add one-sixth plus one-third, and then we're going to subtract. And so one-sixth plus one-third, we want students to know that, let's see, well, one-third is the same thing as two-sixths. So if we add those together, we're going to get three-sixths. So you'll notice I just jump straight to like a lowest common denominator in this case. I didn't do the area model. So at this point, it's appropriate for students to start to develop strategies for how to find a common denominator, but one that is probably more convenient or efficient than just simply using that area model, which would have given us a denominator of 18. So using a common sense, in this case, we're going to start developing common sense here as well. So in this case, we've learned that these two together is equal to three-sixths, which three-sixths, and that means the boys over here is whatever's left over, and that is also three-sixths, because three-sixths plus three-sixths is equal to one whole. So how much did the boys eat? The friends ate three-sixths of the pie, which is equal to one half. All right, let's do another one. So Tiffany bought 2/5 kilogram of cherries. Linda bought 1/10 kilograms of cherries less than Tiffany. How many kilograms of cherries did they buy all together? So in this case, I'm going to do a double bar. I'm going to do double tape diagram, I guess is what I should call it. I'm going to label them T and L, and I'm going to give them both the exact same tape diagram, and I'm going to try and make it as equal as I can. So they're both exactly equal. Now I'm going to go back and I'm going to read the problem again. So it says Tiffany bought 2/5 kilograms of cherries. So that means we can label this 2/5. And then it says, Linda bought 1/10 kilograms less. So what that means is I need to chop off this tape diagram by 1/10. And so the first step that we need to do is figure out, well, how much did Linda purchase? And then the second step is figure out how much do they have all together. So the first thing we need to do is figure out Linda, how many kilograms of cherries Linda bought. So that's going to be 2/5 minus 1/10. It's 2/5 minus 1/10 because we know Linda's tape diagram started out originally as the exact same length as Tiffany's, but then we have to cut it off by, or reduce it, or subtract it by 1/10. So it's going to be 2/5 minus 1/10. Is going to give us the remaining piece. And so using a little common sense, we can see that that's going to be 4/10 minus 1/10, which is equal to 3/10. So Linda has purchased, so her piece right here is 3/10. And so now we're going to add Tiffany's 2/5 plus Linda's 3/10. And so that becomes 4/10 plus 3/10 equals 7/10. So teachers, parents, you might have to do some talking as to how do we know that 2/5 is equal to 4/10, all right? Same thing up here, 2/5 is equal to 4/10. These are really simple common denominators, but you may have to go back and explain why that is the case. The way I would do it personally, 2/5, I would say, well, quick explanation for why 2/5 is the same as 4/10, is you can say, well, here's 2/5, 2/5. But if you cut that in half, suddenly 2/5 becomes 4/10, all right? Because we're going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2. And the last problem for this video, ribbon A is 1/3 meter long. It is 2/5 shorter than ribbon B. What is the total length of the two ribbons? So again, I'm going to do a double tape diagram, and I'm going to start with A and B being the exact same length. And it says ribbon A is 1/3 meter long. So there's my 1/3. And it, meaning ribbon A, is 2/5 of a meter shorter than ribbon B. So that means ribbon B is actually longer by 2/5 of a meter. All right. And then the question is, what is the total length of the two ribbons? Well, in order to get that answer, we're going to need to figure out the total length of ribbon B. So we know that this piece right here is 1/3. So in order to figure out the total length of B, we're just going to have to add 1/3 plus 2/5. But then we know that we need to also then add them together. So we're going to also add in ribbon A. So really, to get the total, we're going to add 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 2/5. So let's just change this to 2/3, because that's 1/3 plus 1/3. So there's our 2/3. Now we're going to add 2/5. So I'm going to scroll down a little bit, and our common denominator is going to be 15. So I'm going to write this down, 2/3 plus 2/5 equals, and we're going to change our denominators to 15. So we can see that, let's see, well, 2/3 times 5 times 5 gives us 10/15. And then 2/5 times 3 times 3 gives us 6/15. And all told, that equals 16/15. And 16/15 is equal to 1 whole and 1/15 left over. And as I recall, that was meters, but we'll check. So the answer is 1 1/15 meters. And yep, it says meters. So there is our work right here. The important thing is that's what the bar diagram, the tape diagram, would look like. It's not the only way to draw the tape diagram. It's just probably the most common way of doing it. And then down here is the mathematics. And that's grade 5, module 3, lesson 7, using tape diagrams to solve two-step word problems.